Ladies and gentlemen, our Shiur Torah Wednesday night, that of Gemara, is the usual Leilu Nishmat Ha'ish HaKasher VeYashar Mula Betzalel Ben Rivka Ruach Hashem Lechanu Megan Eden Tehiyeh Nishmato Tzerura Betzor HaChaim. Ladies and gentlemen, the topic of tonight, is when Alexander Mogdon, the great Alexander, meet the rabbis. When Alexander Mogdon, the Gemara said, Masechet Amid, Aflamed Amud Bet, the Gemara shared with us a story. Alexander Mogdon was a very, very young person that almost conquered the whole world. Our sages said that Alexander Mogdon died in the age of 33, only the great Alexander, the one that almost conquered the whole world, died in a very young age. But he was a very wise man. Not only strong physically, some said he was beautiful physicality, but he was also a very smart man. When he came to the Negev is south, is the reason that he spoke with Chachmei HaNegev is two reasons. One reason is, our sages said, I would say to Achim Chacham Yaakov, what will he do? Yadrim. You know that? And Kodesh HaKodeshim, in Bet HaMikdash, we had two items. One of them symbolized wisdom, the other one symbolized wealth. Which one symbolized wisdom, which one symbolized wealth? The menorah symbolized wisdom. And what symbolizes wealth? The Shulchan. The Shulchan, the Mizbeach, symbolizes wealth. Shulchanu shel Adam, ze Mizbeach. Now, where exactly the Mizbeach used to be? When exactly the menorah? The menorah was always in the south, and the Mizbeach is always in the north. So they said until today, and by the way, in Israel, and I believe in most of the world, the rich country is always in the north. The north of Israel, and even the north of a city, Atzfonim they call them, right? Atzfonim, they're always the rich one. Adromim, by nature, they're always, not coincident, they're always Moroccan and very smart, but money was not the strongest achievement that they had in life. Living in a simple house with a simple life. So no wonder why Alexander Mogdon went into the Darom, Chachmei HaNegev. Negev was in the south. He went over there in order to speak with the wisest people in Eretz Israel that used to live in the south. This is one reason. By the way, because of that, our sages said, if you want to become wise, if you have a test, if you have an obstacle of learning, or if you just want to become Talmid Chacham, you want to have a good memories, great achievement, amazing understanding. What do you have to do? When you pray Shmona Esre, tint a little to the south. Tint a little to the south. Arotze le'achkim yadrim. If you want to become rich, if you want to become wealthy, what do you have to do if you need a job? If you need parnasa unlimited, what do you have to do? Tint a little to the north. I would say Le'ashir Yatzpin. Because of that, was a rabbi that said, because of that we have three tefillot. One tefillah to ask for wisdom. Another tefillah to ask for richness, for money. And another tefillah to pray to the Almighty God, to give you both. This way you can stand still. You don't have not to go to the north, and that's amazing. Second reason, Yudah, listen to this. The second reason that he spoke with Chachmei HaNegev, Negev is the only place. You know, they said when you want to tell a person that is dry, dry, with no physical benefits, מה אומרים לו בעברית? אתה יבש כמו הנגב. Right? You know why you ask Chachmei HaNegev? Because they are symbolized people that had nothing to do with this physical world. Alexander Mogdon was the symbolizer of people that liked to enjoy, liked to live life to the fullest. drinks, physical temptation, everything that meets, eating, all the enjoyment in this world he knew. And he went in to speak with people that had nothing to do with this achievement of the world, nothing to do with this enjoyment. Chachmei Negev. Now you understand why he asked? The Gemara said he asked them 10 different questions. He asked, he challenged them in 10 different questions. And after he finished, oh, by the way, all of them answer in the same time. All of them answer the same answer just to see what the wisdom they had. And after he finished, he crowned each one of them with a special clothing and shersheraot shel zahav, a gold and diamonds jewelry, he gave each one of them gift because of their advice. Listen to the questions, some questions we know and some questions we're going to discuss today. I'm not sure that we're going to finish all the 10 questions, but at least let's start. The first question, well, not the first, I will not go in orders. I will going to go with the one that I want to share some ideas behind. One of the questions that he asks is, Mi hu chacham? Eize hu chacham? Who is a wise man? Now, Alexander Mokdon was a very arrogant man. In our religious, we know that the greatest people, one of the greatest qualities that the great men have is what? Humility. Moshe Rabbeinu lo nishtabeach ela be'anava, sheneemar ve'aish Moshe anav me'od. Moshe Rabbeinu was the extremely person that symbolized what? Humility. Nothing is better from having humility. In the physical world, in the secular world, humility will not lead you to nothing. So Alexander the Great, that achieved so much in wisdom, and achieved so much, conquer any land that exists, came in, and he thought that he's the wisest. So he came to the rabbi and said, Eizehu chacham, who is a wise man? Who is a wise man? Now, there we have an answer that we know from Pirkei Avot, and they give them a different answer. That actually is the same. Chacham Yaakov, what's the answer that we have in Pirkei Avot? Eizehu chacham, alomed mikol adam. Alexander, you're not the smartest. You're not. You want to be the smartest? We will teach you how. Not the way that you think, it's about you. A person that have the ability to study from anyone around you, from any incident around you, you are a wise man. How do they call it? Street smart, book smart, from anything, from lowest people and from rich people, from any ad that you see, any ad that you see. You know me for many few years, and I love to use ad of others. One time I gave a class, the class says, you can do it, we can help. I went into Home Depot, and I saw this slogan that they have. And I love it. I love it. What a beautiful idea. And I was thinking, this is my job, being a rabbi. My job is not to do the job for you, Chas V'Shalom. My job is only to be a messenger of God, to tell you that you can do it. Each one of you, God believe in each one of you and each one of us, that we can succeed. All what we need is help. Our job is to help. Just to help you together. Not to do the job for you. Parents' job is not to do the job for their children. It's to lead them to succeed in their own life. You can do it. We can help. You see, from anything that one of the classes that I gave, it was, you got the questions. We, with God's help, have the answer. It was a question of answer class. For 1 year, my class was an open topic. It was no topic. Every night, it was questions and any topic. And differently, it was a very, very difficult, very challenging class. And how do we call this class? You got the questions. Where did I saw it from? Radio Shack. You know what's the commercial of Radio Shack? You got the questions. We got the answer. The Radio Shack. So I took it in and I said, wow. You got the question. We, with God's help, not Chas V'Shalom that we have any answer. Hashem is the one that have the answer. We are only delivering what the Torah said. What a beautiful. Anything that you see in the world, the Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh said, from everything that you see is a message to your life. איזה הוא חכם, הלומד מכל אדם. They said, הרואה את הנולד. A wise man in business, a wise man in life, a wise man in relationship. Moshe, when you're going to go to get married, how do I know that you're going to be a smart man? You're going out on a date. If you're choosing your wife only because of beauty, I'm not going to say that you're foolish. Maybe yes, but I'm not saying if the only reason is because of beauty, you don't predict the future. You don't choose for the future. You see, when a person educates his own child, when you do action, any action in life, don't think only about today. Think how these actions will affect your future. איזהו חכם הרואה את הנולד. Alexander, maybe you're great now, but he wanted to go to Africa. They told him, don't go to Africa. The darkness places. You're going to lose yourself over there. You're going to die. He went, and this is what happened. You have to see the future. You have to predict the future. In business world, what do they tell you? You have to think 3 steps ahead, 4 steps ahead. More steps, more wisdom. איזהו חכם הרואה את הנולד. When people come to ask me questions, some questions I don't answer in purpose at the same time, you know that? Some questions I don't answer. If this is a serious questions, I need one night to review the questions, to sleep on it, to pray to the Almighty God to give me Sadat Ishmael, and only then I'm answering. Because, you know, certain questions will affect everything that we're going to do in life. I had a question last night when a person took me in all the way from Manhattan. I went with the subway last night. So when I went back, he took me in and he said, Rabbi, I need to ask you. And he asked me a question that my answer will affect his life forever. His life. It's very common, but I didn't answer. I didn't respond fast. I said, listen, let's wait one night, 2 nights, and 2 nights we're going to go in, we're going to pray in the grave of the Lubavitcher Rebbe. We're going to ask the Almighty God to give us some inspiration, and only then I will give you the answer. הרואה את הנולד. Moshe, every action that we do in effect, Tzvi, not only today, affect our future forever. This is who is a wise man. When he asks, who is a gibor, who is a strong man? Who is a strong man? If somebody will ask you, who is a strong man, what's going to be your answer?
Who's strong? Yes.
Who is a strong man? A man that going into the gym for 3 hours and he look like a Popeye, you know Popeye? This is a strong man because he's a balata.
Oh, he's a wise man is strong.
Very nice. Not wise. I will say it beautiful, but the idea is amazing. A man that can control his own behavior, anger, temptation. I mean, you know, one of the things that religion has given us, one of the gifts of religion is to be free. What's meant to be free? I will tell you, people think that to be religious is to be slave. And I'm telling you, you're wrong. To be religious is the only way to be free. You know why? Because from a young age, they teach you to have completely self-control. What do you see it? Very simple. You want to eat? How many times you saw children that asking the father when they want ice cream, Abba, this ice cream is kosher or not? This is Chalav Israel or Chalav Ishmael? How many times you saw people like that? Never. In the secular world, you will never see it. They're screaming, shouting, they're fainting on the mall in front of everybody. The father had no choice, they have to buy. From young age, we're teaching the children, when you have temptation for the food, before you eat, you have to ask if this is kosher or not. One breaks, you put breaks. Another one is, even chumrut. Another one is, you cannot eat outside, you look like animals. You have to eat in the house. You have to eat b'makom tzanua, in a close place. You have to sit down, not to eat, when you're walking. Certain manners, that Allah teach you manners. And not only that, before you come in to swallow the food, to jump in, you have to wash your hand. After you wash your hand, על נטילת ידיים. אחרי על נטילת ידיים, המוציא. אחרי המוציא, you finish ברכת המזון. You know how many breaks you're making? You know how many stops you're making? Why? Maybe to teach you to have self-control in your own physical and animal behavior. You see what's the difference? Eizehu gibor, akovesh et yitzro. What I'm telling you tonight is one of the most difficult things to do. You can see a great people, chazakim, strong people. We all know the fight that we had, one of the famous fights, and not that I'm an expert in fight, one of the famous fight in kickboxing was one of the strongest guys in the world, I mean nowadays, that he took the bite from the other, right? Do you remember that fight? He took the bite, animal. He went into the jail for a few years. I mean, you are so strong, you have so much money, but you cannot lose. He cannot control his own temptation. Yes, he's strong physically, very weak spirituality. You hear that? Very simple. Strong doesn't affect. Because how that somebody came to me and said, Rabbi, you can be the strongest person in the world physically, but in our days, all what it takes to kill you is one bullet. So today you don't need to be strong, you just have to have enough weapons that you can blow the whole neighborhood. You see? So strong doesn't anymore measure by the size of the body or by how many hours. No, this is not making. The only way to define a strong man is a man that has the ability, self-control. Wow. That one is the most difficult one. Why is the most difficult? Because how many times in life somebody offends you and you want to react and you want to respond? Happened to us on a daily basis. You know what it means to control yourself and not to behave? Not to. But you're right. Rabbi, I was right. Why I'm not going to tell him? What the crook man? What the Rasha? Why I'm not going to bless him to go to Gehenna? Why that I need to be always the tzaddik? Eizehu gibor, akovesh et yitzro. Person that have a self-esteem, not self-esteem, self-control, is a strong man. He continued and he asked, who is a rich man? Yehuda, today I saw a story, and listen to this story, a beautiful story. The story said this way. He was once a rich man that always had worries. He always had worries. He didn't sleep, not during the day and not during the night. The only what bothered him after a while is that the reason that he's not sleep at night is not only because of business. He started because of business, but then bothered him something. What? His neighbor, the poor man, every night and every day, the whole day singing, dancing, so happy. Now this rich man said, there's no way. I mean, I have a palace. How come this guy that living in an apartment building, one bedroom for the whole family, 8 children, and he's always happy? And he's singing through the windows, his windows in my house. His windows is four floor. My palace is 5 floors, and my window of the bedroom, and his windows, is the same windows. And every night I hear him singing. He said, there's no way. He called this poor man and said, what's the secret? I mean, I don't understand. Do you have enough money? He said, my dear friends, if you already ask, I don't have even money to pay the rent this month. He said, do you have enough money to pay the wish of 8 children? He said, no. I barely have enough money for one child. So he said, so why are you singing all day? He said, Baruch Hashem, thank God. I have children, I have wife, I have everything. Everything that I want. He said, so why are you singing? He said, Baruch Hashem, thank God. He said, what, you don't need money? He said, I didn't say that I don't need money. I said that I have everything. He said, you know what? Listen to how smart was the rich man. He said, I will give you a gift. I'm giving you right now $250,000 gift. But you have one condition, two conditions actually. One condition is that you have to keep the money and you can use it. Second condition, only after 1 year. You have to keep the money in the house and only in the second year you can use it. Meaning you have to keep it in your house for 1 year. What did the poor man said? Mazal. He gave him the money in a suitcase. $250,000. He put it under the bed. And then he stopped to think, why? All day long he's worried. He's worried who is going to steal, who is not. He started to put, bars in the windows. He bought a special door with camera. And every time, he bought the camera that you can connect it to the phone to check the house 24 hours. He was on, Yudah, after 3 months, we gave him the money back. He said, listen, I have $250,000 and you took my happiness. I don't even use the money and you already took my happiness. At least I enjoy it. I have to wait another 9 months to enjoy it. Take the money and leave me alone. I was happy before. Why you made me miserable? Marbe nechasi, marbe deaga. What they told Alexander Mogdon, the great Alexander. You can conquer the whole world, but it will never be enough. You want to be a rich man? The only way is asameach bechelko. Moshe, when I define the word ani, a poor man, what is a poor man? Can you tell me a definition of a poor man? What is a poor man? Meaning what?
Ungrateful.
Okay, ungrateful is beautiful.
A person who's not happy?
But why? Why is that happy?
This person,
I will tell you today explanation, a simple explanation that maybe you never heard before. Simple explanation, and this is what they told Alexander Mogdon. The great Alexander didn't know this definition. If he came to Wednesday night, the death of Gemara, maybe his life would be a whole different life. Here in BJCC, Yot Minyan, the third floor, place to be. A place that changed people's mind and heart. A place that inspired thousands of people to get closer and closer to the Almighty God. Ladies and gentlemen, Chaim Yaakov, what is the problem? תסביר לי אתה מה זה אני. אני, מה הכוונה? איך אתה מגדיר אני? מי זה אני?
זה
לא עצוב. אמרתי אני. איך מגדירים אני?
למה הוא עצוב?
למה הוא עצוב? תגדיר לי אני, yes, sorry.
Are we labeling him as אני, or he's saying this?
How do you label אני and definition?
How do we label them?
Yes. אני meaning what? Not we. We label people that have no money to be אני. Today I will tell you that this is wrong. This definition is wrong by nature. The essence of the definition is wrong. No. אני is something, someone that doesn't have what he wants, right?
Yes.
If you want to have a house and you don't have a house, you consider to be ani. Ani is the adam shechaser lo mashu shu rotze lasig, nechon? Ain lo, hu ani.
Yes.
So, beautiful. If you have no house, if you have no children, if you have no money, if you have no job, why? Because you want it so bad. So ani is only a person that misses something that he really wants, right? Beautiful. If I can find you a person that have everything that you want, he have everything that he wants. He have everything that he wants. He is ani or not? He is a poor or not? Is that poor? Because it doesn't miss that illness. So many people that we consider poor, they are the happiest people in the world. Why? Because they have everything. In their eyes, they have everything. Everything that they need and everything that they want, they have. You hear that? If we define poor by missing something, so when a person doesn't miss anything, he's a rich man. He's rich because he has everything. Now, you can be a billionaire, but if you want another billion, not only that you're not rich, you are the poorest person. Why? Because you're not only poor, now you're missing another billiard. So you pull $1 billion away. You hear that? Simple and brilliant. You hear that? Ani is a person that miss. As long as you don't miss anything. They said about once he was a king. It depends on your inside feeling. If you have everything that you ever wish and desires, you are a rich man.
בגלל זה.
אתה רואה, זה מה שחזן אמרו. מרבה נכסים, מרבה דאגה. אדם שיש לו נכסים, עכשיו מתחיל הדאגות. אדם קונה בית, מי עכשיו יש לו דאגה? למה? אם הוא לא משנה מורגץ', זה הבית, הוא מפציד את הבית שלו. לפני זה לא היה לו דאגה. לא שאני משחק, דרך לא קרה כלום. חודש, חודשיים, מה יקרה? הוא לא מפסיד כלום. הוא מפסיד מקום מגורים, אבל זהו. עכשיו, אדם קנה רכב, כל שריטה ברכב עושה לו שריטה בלב. בליסין, אין לך בעיה. אתה שם $5,000 ביטוח, תשרוט. אתה אומר לו, תשרוט, תמשיך ותשרוט. הפוסים דת און סמטן, תסתדו לי בנפס און, זה עושה נגטיבית, מה זה נגטיבית? Every scratch that they make in your car, you feel the scratch in your heart. When you don't pay the mortgage, you know that you're going to lose your house, not the rent house. But the more money that you have, this is the nature. I will tell you, you ask a bit of a question, Chama Yaakov, listen to this. There was once a king that he was sick. He became very, very sick. The doctor told him the only way to be healthy, he was mentally sick and physically, is to find a happy man, and to wear his shirt. To put his shirt on you. His shirt will give you some happiness and you're going to be happy. He went and he started to search. Where can he find? Suddenly he realized that all his ministers, none of them is happy. This one have a fight with his wife, this one with the children, this one the children hate him, this one the son-in-law hate him, the other guy lost his money, this one is gambling, this one in drug, nobody. He went all over the states, all over the country, each one, few countries, few states. He's moving from a country to another, he doesn't find. Until he sees a shepherd singing with Khalil, la 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 la. He was there for 1 hour. And he sees the guy is so happy. He came day after and again. The whole day he's happy. Another day. Baruch Hashem, thank God I find one guy happy from so many countries. So they say, he sent right away. His messenger has to call him. He called him and said, listen, you are my medicine. I need you short. Give me you short. If I will wear you short, I will be happy. This is what my doctor told me. The poor man said, my dear king, you know what's the problem? First of all, yes, I'm happy. I'm happy because I have everything that I want. And the only problem is that I have no short. Because if I'm going to have a short, I'm not going to be happy. So what's the connection? So because if I'm going to have a short, I'm going to have to iron. And then I'm going to have to send it to cleaners. And cleaners cost money. I'm working like a Tarzan and that's it. No short, no pain, no nothing. I'm not saying it, God forbid, to be a message. Just understand the message behind. Even a shirt that you have, you cannot sleep at night. Why? Because now you have to pay for the shirt. And you have to make sure, and if not, you're going to have to buy a new shirt. And then you have to send it to the cleaners. And after that, you heard that? Even a simple shirt can make a person not happy. That's the message. Eizu Ashir Asameach B'chilko. He asked himself, Ma Yaaseh Adam V'yamut. Gentlemen, I spoke about it in Shabbat. And I want to repeat it for the sake of others to hear it again and again and again. Because I believe that our challenge in our generation is this one. When you ask the wisest people of Ashkelon, Chachmei HaNegev, what exactly a person needs to do in order to be alive? You know what they answer him? He needs to die. When you ask what exactly a person needs to do in order to be dead, they said you have to be alive. What's the explanation? What's the meaning of these questions? With that, we're going to conclude. Ladies and gentlemen, in Shabbat we spoke, we explained. One of the challenges in our generation is, Chaim Yaakov, listen and listen well, that we are multitask. Multitask meaning, we send in messages, we check in the internet, and we come to Shiur Torah. At the same time. We're driving, texting, speaking on the phone, and we're doing everything. So it's a great thing. When you're going outside on a date and you want to show your future wife that you are multitask, something that we have to be proud in it, right? And I say just the opposite. The worst thing that you can do is to be proud that you are multitask. Multitask, הכוונה, זה אדם שיכול לעשות כמה מלאכות באותו זמן. This is a horrible character, and a very negative one. Why? Ask me, Rabbi, why? In our society, the more that you can do, the more respect that you get. Tzvi, listen. You know what's the problem with the multitask? You do a lot, but none of them you do right. It's better to do one thing at a time and to do it right from doing 10 things and none of them is right. My mashpia in the yeshiva, Rav Menachem Mendel, foot of us, when I was a bachur, Moishele, in your age, he used to tell me, Asher, when you go into the mikveh, be in the mikveh, when you pray, pray, when you eat, eat, when you say Birkat HaMazon, say Birkat HaMazon, when you walk, walk, what's the chedosh? Why, is it come to reveal America? Yes. Our generation, when we pray, the Kotzke Rebbe one time came into a chosid after Tefillah, and he told him, Shulum Aleichem. The chassid said, Kvod Rav, why are you telling me Shulum Aleichem? I'm here for 2 weeks. Shulum Aleichem, you're telling the person that you didn't see him decade. I'm here every day. 3 times a day, I'm praying with you. The rabbi said, yes. But when I looked at you, I saw you in the middle of the Tefillah. How that you fly to China to buy the merchandise. And now that you sold it in New York. And now that you spend the money in Cancun, in Bura Bura, in Gehinnom. And you're sitting down in a vacation, and you're smiling. And everything happened when? In Shmona Yisrael. When you pray, pray. Don't play with the phone. Don't send text messages. Not only, like we explained until now, because of lack of respect. No doubt that the rabbi is right. To take the phone away is mitzvah. Obligation, but even more so. It's not only because you, when you pray, when you do something, do it right. When you pray, be focused in the tefillah. Maybe this is one of the reasons that our tefillot is so difficult to be heard by God. It's so difficult to be answered by God. Why? Because you're not praying. It's not a question if you forgot to say Ya'aleh ve'yavo, or you forgot even if you pray Shacharit or not, that I put the feeling today or not. Why? Because you're not focused. How many of us eating for food? How many of us focusing when we eat? None of us. What do we do when we eat? We're talking, we send a text message, we're talking on the phone, everything doing the food. You know, did you ever enjoy food for food? You hear that? You hear that? How many times happened to us, and this is for the adult, the older people here, that when your child asks you, Abba, what did they say? What did they say?
No.
When they talk to you, not when they come to you and say, not now. They talk to you, and you play like you listen. Let me tell you, send text messages or whatever you... And then they ask, what did you say? What did they say? How many times happened that your wife told you that? And you said, yes, yes, you remember the last word. But the last word is not what I said. I spoke 25 minutes before that, the last word. Shalom, you say shalom. Somebody, every time his wife asks him, what do you say? Shopping. Because you know that this is the weak boy, the weakest point of his wife. Ladies and gentlemen, do we really listen to our children? Are we really listening to our children? That we really praying, that we really focusing on Birkat HaMazon, that we really focusing in our job, loyalties. When you ask, what exactly a person need to do in order to be alive, their answer was, to die. To die meaning you want to be alive, make anything else in that moment dead. This is the reason that we call present, present. You know, yesterday I explained in Tuesday night class in Safra, I explained three words in English that every American person knows and nobody understands what the meaning. We have 3 words that define our life. What is the three word that define our life? Very simple. Past, future, and present, right? At any moment. Is either in your past, future, and the present. And I explained them in a simple English. What is past, nobody knows. I said, is the reason that they call the past, past. You know why they call it past? Passed away. Rahmat kulam. Kaddish yadom. In order that you're not going to dig in your past, Many people stop succeeding in life when you ask them why, what did they say? I grew up in this kind of family, my father didn't like me, and the school I was miscanned, they call it a past, in order that you're going to put it in the past. Not that you're going to live with it. You hear that? You know why they call it future? Because future is something that you cannot know. It's future. It's not now. I know people that they didn't even get married. I tell the guy, cheap, stingy. Why all day long you saving money? He said, Rabbi, my children one day they're going to go to college. I need to save money. First of all, get married. They're like, which children are you talking? People saving money. What's going to happen next year, 3 years from now, 5 years from now? Go to any insurance, go to any doctors, and pay him $1 million. And tell him one condition. Guarantee 100% that I'm going to live for 1 month. 1 month. And if not, you're going to pay me $10 million. And nobody will ever do it. No insurance company, no life insurance will ever pay for it. Nobody can guarantee you 1 month, 1 week, 1 day. You plan yourself for what's going to happen 10 years from now? They call it the future because it's future. The only time that you are here is the present. Gift. You know why present is a gift? Avar, ein. Ahove, minayin. Atid, minayin. Ahove, ben hatayim. The only moment in life that you enjoy is this moment. So be present. They told Alexander Mugdon, but he didn't get the message. Stop conquering the whole world. Stop swallow the world. Enjoy what you have. And you have everything that every other person wishes and desires to have. You hear that? They call it be present in English. Be present. In Hebrew, Liot Nuchach. Be there. Be there. This is maybe the greatest message in our life that our generation is lacking so much. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm talking to all of us, including the speaker. This time, including the speaker. 100%. We drive and text. We don't text good and we don't drive good. Did you realize how many mistakes you're doing? Sometimes you're sending courses to a person. And he's going, why are you cursing me? What is? I thought that you love me, you are my enemy. I'm sorry, it was a mistake, I was driving. Okay. Everybody understand, when you're driving, you cannot literally put the right. How many times you change the word, right? So you're not texting, right? And you're not driving, right? You put yourself and somebody else in danger of life and death. So why were we doing it? Because we are multitask. Wow, multitask. Ladies and gentlemen, let's stop being multitask. Let's do whatever we were doing and do it right. You come to Shiur Torah, spend it in Shiur Torah. You're going out on a date, be in a date. Don't be all over. I know some people, when they're going out on a date, you know what they're doing? In order to do show off, they come with 3 phones and every phone is ringing and the guy is talking like, hello, yes, what is the business deal? And the woman is looking. First of all, what's this nonsense? And second, it doesn't respect me. You came here to spend with me or you came here to answer the phone? When you're going on a date, you're going to answer the phone. You're going to be in the date. You come to pray to the Almighty God. Be there. Be present. Be present. What the sages teach Alexander Mugdon is, you want to be a wise man? Study from anyone. Predict the future. Think that every decision that you make will change the future. You want to be a strong man, the only way is to be religious. Why? Religious teach you how to self-control yourself. Self-control your animal desires. Self-control your spawn, your anger, your stinginess, your laziness. Self-control. You want to become a rich man? Very simple. Be happy in what you have. Be happy. This is the only way. Because if not, you can have billions and you are the poorest person alive. Why? Because if you have 10 billion and you're missing and you want to have 20, how much you miss? You see, if I have 50,000 and I want to have 100, how much I miss? 50,000, right? If this guy have 10 billion and he want to have 20, how much is missing? So who is more poor, him or me? You hear that? Less that you have, richer that you get. That one you cannot study, not in Yale, not in Princeton, not in Stanford, not in Harvard, and even not in Columbia. Only in BJCC, at Minyan Third Floor. The Academy of Torah. The Academy of Torah. The Academy of Torah. A place that giving unlimited Torah with unconditional love. This is our place, BJCC. Ladies and gentlemen, especially the one, we are the one that watching the internet and all the website, the kosher website, the one of them is Torah Anytime, a blessed one, and known Torah as well. And any website that brings light in this darkness place. But Moreover, Rabotai, the last message, you want to be alive? You want to be dead? As you remember, be present. Be where you are. Don't spread yourself all over. It was a guy that came to the first Chabad Rebbe, and he said, Rebbe, I feel that everybody in the synagogue step on me. Step on me. So you know what the Rebbe answered him? Stop spreading yourself all over the synagogue. Choose a chair and sit over there. You're spreading yourself all over. Everybody is stepping. You feel that life is stepping on you? You feel that you have so many obstacles in life? Stop spreading yourself all over. Business and some people, they have money, electronic, diamonds, houses, this. There are as many businesses. They're spreading themselves. When you do something, do it right. Do it right. Be focused. Be present. What a message. Chachmei HaNegev. People that have nothing to do with physicality. People that choose religion, that choose wisdom over their own physical body, but they know this world even better from the great Alexander. And this is the message to all of us. May God will give all of us the blessing to be rich, to be small, strong, to be smart, and to be alive, to be present. Thank you very much.